Okay, Bismillah, welcome back, folks. We're looking at calculating A as a percentage of B done by myself, Mr. Imran Iqbal, from Imran Iqbal 1-to-1 Tutor on YouTube. Right, question number one. The question that we have here for our students today is express 12 as a percentage of 25. Now, when we write that down, we need to first of all convert this English sentence into a fraction. So, on the top, we put the first number. What is the first number? 12. As a percentage of 25, 25 goes on the bottom. So the first number goes on the top, and the second number in the question goes on the bottom. Now that we converted the English verbal sentence into a fraction, the next question is, students, how do we change this fraction into a percentage? What do we do, Mr. Moyes?
Times it by 100.
Times it by 100. To change a fraction into a percentage, we can do times by 100 as one of the methods, or we could use an equivalent technique as another method. There are lots of methods. But we're going to just times it by 100 over 1 using an old school tradition method. That's just one of the methods we could use. So, now what do we do now, Alishpa? We try to cancel, if we can, diagonally. So I'm looking at this diagonal here. Can I cancel the diagonal? And the answer is?
Yeah.
What can I cancel by? Well, I can cancel by dividing by?
25.
25, well done. So we say 25 divided by 25 is?
1.
100 divided by 25 is?
4.
4. Now, can we cancel this vertically, 12 and 1? Can we cancel 12 and 1?
No.
No, because 1 is already simple. Can we cancel 4 and 1 vertically?
No.
Because 1 is already as simple as it'll get. Now, the technique now is we multiply at the top numbers. What's the top numbers? 12 times by 4. Where's 12? There's 12. And there's 4. And the bottom numbers are 1 times by?
1.
1 times by 1. So 12 times by 4 will give us?
36.
48.
Oh.
1 times by 1 will give us? 1. And 48 divided by 1 will give us a lovely answer of 48%. That's showing you nice, lovely, easy numbers, chunky numbers that we can work with quite easily. Now, let's look at the next question, which looks a little bit complicated, but it's actually one of the questions that we just done today in our, what was the name of that test?
Numerical
Reasoning, short test 7. Okay, CEM style paper. So even though it looks complicated, we're going to have a look at how we can do the same question. So, let's have a go. So, we draw our fraction. So, the first number goes on top. The second number that is off, is this as a percentage of that one, goes on the bottom. And then what do? We do the same that we've just done. We times by
100
over 1. Now, so the cancelling is going to be the same as before. So 25 divided by 25 is 1. 100 divided by 25 is 4. Here comes only the difference. Now 24.2 won't cancel by anything in the moment. So we left with now is the two top numbers times this number. Now times by the so two top numbers times together. 24.2 times by 4 over. What's on the bottom? It is 1 times by.
1.
That's a really hard question. 1 times by 1. Which is? 1. Now 24.2 times by 4. If you want to work it out on the side, we just work it out quickly over here. Over here. 24.2 times by 4. So, 4 times. Because we've got one decimal place in the question, we'll have one in the answer. 4 times by 2 is 8, 4 times by 4 is 16, 2 times by 4 is 8 and 1 is?
9.
So we get over here 96.8. Now, students, before you start worrying, oh, I've got a decimal on top of a fraction, it doesn't matter for this type of question because it says 96.8 divided by 1. 96.8 divided by 1 will give us a grand total of? 96.8%. And that's the end of this particular small short video. We'll have some more questions to follow. Okay.